What up, everyone? MichaelBePetty here. It's been a while since I've made a video, and I am very sorry about that. I got over the flu, which then turned into bronchitis, so if I don't sound like myself, or I'm still dealing with like all the phlegm and the mucus in my chest, I'm going to be editing out a lot of coughs, me sounding like a sick mess. But it's been a while since I've uploaded a video, and I've been wanting to upload a video, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. This topic has been on my brain for a very long time, and I've been grappling with wanting to like talk about it because I feel at times I feel like I am not really in the best, like I feel like almost my opinion isn't really that valid on it because it doesn't really affect me per se, but at the same time I have an opinion on it and I want to talk about it. And that is my feelings on kids on social media or like on YouTube in general. What all triggered this for me, or everything that kind of just like got this kind of going in my head, was like an article I read around the Thanksgiving time, and I found it to just be so incredibly ridiculous, but so kind of indicative of the kind of culture of social media that we're in now, where like exploiting our kids for clicks and money on YouTube is like just a thing now. I want to read it to you and kind of just like talk a little bit more about like my feelings towards kids being on social media, so, and having such a presence on social media. So I'm gonna go ahead and read this to you. I'm gonna put it up so you can read it too at the same time. But anyway, this is what it says. I'm not gonna put the person's name or anything like that in it. I mean, if you type in what I say, you can go and find the person, but it is what it is. So this is what it is. At first it started out really cool and kind of okay, and it is what it is. It says, thankful for Weston today. My Weston was just the best baby, cuddly and easy, a hard toddler, always on the move and slow to talk, which led to lots of crying, and one of the most helpful and sweethearted little boys. He is quiet except when he's not, overflowing with unique personality. He hates the car and is a complete homebody. He loves art and sports and is quick with a joke. He loves organizing and quality time, and says one day he is going to be a daddy to 100 babies, and when he hugs and kisses you, you believe it. That's cute. I like it. It's whatever. It's gushy, blah, blah, blah. She also put a giant picture up of her kid on there. I have my own thing when it comes to like posting all your kids on social media all the time, and I'm going to get into that. But then she followed it up with this. And this is kind of when it just like went off the rails. She says, guys, I'm going to be perfectly honest. Instagram never liked my munchkin, and it killed me inside. His photos never got as many likes, never got comments. From a statistical point of view, he wasn't as popular with everyone out there. Maybe part of this was the pictures just never hit the algorithm right. Part might be because he was the baby for a very short amount of time before LJ came along, and then Max, and then Ella. And people like babies. I say all that because I want to believe that it wasn't him, that it was on me. My insufficiency caused the statistical deficit because obviously my munch should get all the love, and squinty eyes are totally adorable. So we can do this right, because I truly know that my munchkin gives it to them. And on the 6th birthday, I'm thankful that I know that, and no matter what other people think of me or my kids or my marriage or my house or my life or everything, they are 1,000 whatever, a big ass number, I'm not gonna pretend to count the zeros, better in real life than any little picture could hold. P.S. I wanted to clarify that I revealed this feeling because I know one day he will see the numbers and have to learn that his value is not in online approval. This is a hard lesson for anyone to learn, and I'm thankful I learned it. I hope you all can be understanding and not take things out of context or believe that this is in any way affects how I see or treat my children. All comments and well wishes I read to this birthday boy. Okay, so I remember reading this article and I gave the biggest eye roll of life because I just found it just, so I don't have children, so I don't really understand what it's like to have kids or to be protective of kids. I mean, I'm protective of children in general because I find them, I have like an Arizona Robbins kind of, if you know who I'm talking about, it's a character from Grey's Anatomy. I kind of have like that kind of a respect for children. I like refer to them as like tiny humans because I just think that they're like these adorable creatures that we are supposed to like do everything we can to protect and to nurture and to like make better beings for the future, because children are the future, right? Like Michael Jackson said. Ooh, that's really not a good reference. But you get where I'm saying, right? I have nothing but the utmost respect, and I love kids, and I think they're amazing. Do I want to babysit kids? Not really. Kids either come with two different feelings towards me, it seems like, especially my friend's kids. Either I'm scary because I'm big, and my presence is kind of like a little intimidating, I think, or they think I'm a giant jungle gym. And so they just want to climb and like, they want me to lift them up and throw them around and all that stuff, which is fun and dandy or whatever. I mean, I love kids. I'm thankful that I don't have to like be in charge of one all the time, because I feel like I would like lose my goddamn mind. So I was reading the post and I just thought it was so interesting how she thought that, she was going to put her child's worth on the amount of likes or the amount of the lack of likes that she was receiving on her Instagram posts. Mind you, this is a woman whose profession seems to be a mommy blogger. Like, mommy bloggers in and of themselves can be a little bit problematic, because it's the whole like mommy shame, blah, 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 all that stuff. Like, you don't raise your kids right because I'm doing all this with my kids. Like, not everyone has the luxury to like be a stay-at-home mom and post like amazing Photoshop pictures of their kids and their perfect outfits every day. Like, that's not a true representation of what raising children looks like. So I already am kind of just like biggest eye roll of life when I like stumble upon a mommy blogger. But the fact that she was talking about how her child is going to have to learn this lesson in the future about how his approval isn't based, or his self-worth isn't based upon the approval he receives online. Why is a six-year-old even being subjected to that? Like, I don't understand, because, and this is where I'm going to get in onto a whole nother tangent, I guess, about like kids on social media in general. Kids don't have the ability to consent to being in these pictures, in these videos, in whatever the fuck these parents are putting them in. Like, they don't have the ability to cognitively understand what is happening, to consent to being criticized or praised or whatever online. And it sucks that there's not more of a protection or a more of a concern around that when it comes to these kids. Like, they have no idea how this is going to affect them in the future, how it's not going to affect them in the future, how maybe they don't want to have an online presence when they're older. But guess what? They don't get to make that decision, because it's already out there. It's all out there, and it's all for anyone's taking, and anyone can say or do whatever they want with whatever information that their parents are willing to give to them. And that kind of goes into the whole family vlogger thing. I don't really enjoy family vloggers. I'm not a big vlogger fan in general. Like, I guess if you think of like the vlog squad, I don't even really consider that vlogging. That's a bunch of bits that are put together to make it look like a vlog, but it's all planned and scripted and all that shit. So I don't really consider that vlogging. But I don't really like family vloggers. I don't like couple vloggers. It's just not my cup of tea, mostly because I find it to be incredibly fabricated, and it's not a true representation of what reality is actually like. The thing with family vloggers in general, like couple vloggers, do whatever you want. You're both consenting adults. If you want your relationship to go down in flames, that's all you. But when it comes to family vloggers, I don't feel like there's enough attention being brought to the fact that there are children involved in this. Like, there's children that are being handed a camera and be film your fucking day so I can splice it up and put it online and we can run some ads on it. And I don't understand why we're not thinking about the psychological ramifications of these kids and their whole vlogging career. Like, and it makes me think about all of the Hollywood child actors that have like gone down in flames since at least I've been alive. Like, I think about the Lindsay Lohans. I think about the Macaulay Culkins. I think about all of those kids that, and they weren't vlogging. They were legitimate child actors. They went to a set. They're aware that it's like imaginative or whatever. But like, when you're growing up in a public sphere like that as a kid, you're going to be affected. There's no way that you will be able to come out of that unaffected. And granted, when it comes to Hollywood, there are laws in place to protect kids. I mean, I believe they're called the Coogan laws or the Kogan laws, but they're in place since I think the 20s to like how many hours a day a child can be on set, how much teaching a day a child has to be there, how many hours can a kid be in front of the camera. Like, all of that stuff is in place. And then not only that, but the money that they receive from said career or said acting jobs are put into a bank account that no one can access. It's like put into a trust. So like, no one can touch it until the kid is of age. And I want to know, does that happen on YouTube? Because I feel as though we never hear about that. We never hear about like the fact that these kids are a part of these family vlogs and there's an AdSense account somewhere. Are there hours that are they're only allowed to be in per day or whatever? Because it doesn't seem that way. Are these bank accounts protected? Are these kids going to have money when they get of age? Are they going to be Gary Coleman the fuck house down? Like, I honestly believe that 10 years from now or whatever, when a lot of these big names of these family vloggers, they're of age and they go to access their account, they're gonna be like, where the fuck's the money at? Like, what? Like, why was I doing all these vlogs at 5, 6 years old? And where's the money at? And then not only that, you have to think about like the possible ramifications of a kid not being able to distinguish between reality and what is for camera. So we all know that when a camera is on you, you're going to say and act and do things differently. Now, we're so concerned about kids being exposed to violent natures or violent scenes and imagery on television and video games and all this. And I think that that's a legitimate argument or whatever. But are we going to also like bring to the forefront maybe a discussion about like what it is doing to a kid's psyche to like have to vlog a play date? Or like, you know, like there's just a lot about it that I just don't find very kosher. And I just don't. It just rubs me the wrong way. And we've had examples in the past, I mean, it's very recent of this all going wrong, right? We see and hear about people like Daddy of Five, or we've seen the kinds of things that like Sam and Nia, where they're like literally making up miscarriages for views on YouTube. Like, you see all of this stuff and you're just like, where was the protection? Where was anyone to say this isn't going? And mind you, all of this stuff comes way, like by the time that everyone catches wind of like how negative this might be, it's too late. The damage is done, right? It's like, it's not that fair that for some easy money on YouTube, we're going to like subject these kids to this situation or to this scenario, you know? I think of like, there was one couple that vlogged a long time ago, and I believe their channel's name was Texan in Tokyo, and I believe her name is Katie, and her husband, Ryosuke, and she was essentially about a mixed couple or an interracial couple, and she moves to Japan to like live with her husband, da da da, all that stuff. And they had a very successful channel, and I remember watching their video because they said they were going to close their channel down because they wanted to have kids. And they said that they just didn't want to put their kid on camera. They didn't want like strangers to know about their kids. And I found that to be extremely admirable, because I want to know if these parents or these people think about the fact that you are subjecting your children to the not so nice parts of the internet, right? So like, there's pedophiles out there. There's people that want to do harm to kids or do harm to you. So maybe they'll do harm to you by doing harm to your kids. You're essentially giving a lot of these people all the ammunition they need to intertwine themselves into like a kid's life, right? Like, they know their names, they know when they're born, they know like where they live, like all of this stuff, right? Because the internet it's a wonderful place, but it's also a very scary place. And I want to know if these YouTube families or whatever think about that stuff. Like, if someone really wanted to do something, like all they need to do is watch a couple of videos and know like, oh, she likes this. Oh, this person likes this. Oh, she goes by this nickname. Oh, her parents, her names are this. Her grandparents' names are this. You know, it kind of makes you think about like what could possibly happen. I just find you just want to think like, maybe it's not the best idea to like subject your kids to being in all these vlogs or whatever and to being on camera all the time, because they don't have the ability to consent to it, and they also don't know what they are signing up for. And I mean, I'll take for instance, like, look, I love Colleen Ballinger. Like, I think she's really cool and I think she does really good content and she's a really good person. But it's like, girlfriend just had her baby and that baby's been in like how many videos already? Like, and not only that, she's been in like her friends' videos. So it's like the baby, like, I don't know. Like, it's just like, when is it too much? When are we like crossing the line into like oversharing? And like, can a baby consent to be on camera? Fuck no. So like, maybe the answer to that question is maybe the baby just shouldn't be on camera. And I understand there's the whole argument around, well, these are memories that are being made and the baby will be able to like watch all this in the future. That's a great argument. Like, I understand, like, I mean, I know my mom has home movies, I have pictures and stuff like that, but guess what? She didn't put them on the internet. And when I felt like going back and watching them, or she feels like going back and watching them, she can go back and watch them. It's not, you don't have to put it on YouTube and run ads on it in order for the kid when they're 30 to look back and be like, whoa, that was a really cool experience. Like, not everything needs to be shared with the internet. You know, and I try to tell my friends and stuff who have kids that all the time, like, I get you're proud of your kids and you need to like really make sure that these pictures and everything are not falling into the wrong hands, because that's a very real part of the internet. Okay. So I just think you should like always double check and then like really think about what you're putting on the internet and like, is this going to be conducive to my child when they're older? I mean, could this hurt my child potentially now? Am I giving them too much information? Like, I mean, I know I have friends who've posted pictures of their kids picking them up at school. I'm like, bitch, now everyone knows where your kid goes to school. So they know the kid's name. They know your name. Like, it's just, it's a lot. It's a lot that you're like, and I don't know if it's the society now or if it's the culture that we're a part of now where like we want to just share. And we don't just think about those things anymore because we don't think about them ourselves. I mean, I know that I'm guilty of that. I mean, there have been times where I've posted things and it's like, well, shit, like now everyone knows where I'm at or blah, blah, blah. And it's like, but I'm an adult. So it's like, if something were to happen, I consented to those pictures. I, you know, all of that stuff. Like I did all of that to myself. A kid doesn't get a say in that. So I don't know. I just think that there's like a side of the YouTube vlogger sphere, especially when it comes to family vlogging and kids with channels and stuff. And there's been a bunch of people that have been made a couple of videos talking about like the really not so nice parts of the internet where it's clearly these kids are being like exploited and stuff. And it's gross. And you can find a lot of those videos or whatever. Like, when do we decide that the kids' safety and the kids' psychological needs are more important than like our family making some extra money on YouTube and like essentially branding my kid and its life for a buck on for some AdSense, you know? Like, can't these kids just be kids? Shouldn't they be afforded that ability or that choice to just, you know, live a normal life as a kid that's just a kid that doesn't have to worry about being online, doesn't have to worry about being criticized, doesn't have to worry about the potential dangers? Because there's already going to be dangers out there when you're a kid. But to put it all online, too, is like you're asking for a whole nother gambit of people to come in and potentially harm your child. And it's like, I just think that we need to really think about those things. So I don't know. That was just kind of where my head was, kind of how I was feeling towards that. It's been on my head. Like I said, I read that blog about that woman. Oh, mind you, that woman also didn't understand. That woman is very extreme in a sense, because I've also read a part of one of her blogs where she was talking about how she didn't realize people died during 9/11. So obviously she's probably not the best or the most appropriate or like the best example of like a mommy blogger out there. But from what I've understood and from what I've been able to see is like she's not really that far off from the typical mommy blogger. So, yeah, I just wanted to talk about like, damn, like, can we just let these kids be fucking kids? Like, do they need to be on camera? Do they need to be in vlogs every other day? Hell, I think even like Lance Black and like Tom Daly posting a picture of like their new baby and its legs in a Pampers. And like, it was like an Instagram post. It was a sponsored Instagram post from Pampers. And it's like, do you need to even put the baby in the picture? Like, you can literally, like, you don't have to have the baby in the picture to sell some money. Like, it's a brand new baby. Like, let the baby just be a baby. We're worried about getting brand deals for our baby already? Like, goddamn. Like, it's not that serious. You got money, too. You're like an award-winning director and an Olympic diver. Do you really need the Instagram money? Like, just, like, chill. Ugh, whatever. But anyway, let me know down below if what you think about this stuff, if you've had feelings like this, too. I want to hear them. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Michael B. Petty on Instagram and Twitter. I'm a bit more active on Twitter, so if you want to get a hold of me, that's usually the best way, or on Instagram. Like I said, thank you so much for tuning in, and until next time, toodles.